And that's exactly what we're going to look at next, relationships in the class diagram, how they're represented and what they mean. First of all, relationships, as the name says, describe interactions between classes or between objects in my system. And we will describe three main types of relationships. The first one is called a dependency relationship. And we can express that as X uses Y. And we represent it with a dashed directed line. So when we have such a line between two classes, that means that the first class uses the second one. And we're going to provide an example of a dependency in a minute. The second type of relationship is an association that can also be an aggregation. We'll see what the distinction is. But basically what this means is that we can express that as a X has a Y. So X contains a Y. And if it is an association, we indicate it with a solid undirected line. If it's an aggregation, we indicate it in the same way, but with a diamond at one of the ends. Finally, the third type of relationship is what is called generalization. And that can be expressed as X is a Y. So this is the relationship that expresses inheritance, specialization between two classes. It's represented with a solid directed line with a large open arrowhead at the end, going from the more specialized class to the less specialized class. So going from the subclass to the superclass. So now let's look at each relationship in more detail using our example, our course management system.